resist the negative.
What's up, guys? Be sure to sub to the locals. You get to see a ton of content on here. It's only $4 a month. Really helps us out, obviously, with this platform being in limbo all the time. We don't know what's going to happen next. So be sure to sub to the locals. Bunch of content that's not with us anymore, and a bunch of new stuff too, and stuff from 2019. So be sure to sub to the locals. It will be the pinned comment. It's only $4 a month, very cheap. And we got some spicy Stinghouse footage on here, and we got some stuff that I'm very scared to release on this platform. So be sure to sub to locals. It lets us enables us to keep traveling the most and catching the sickest. All you got to do, help support us here, $4 a month. Anyway, enjoy the video. Be sure to sub to the Rumble too in the pinned comment. Sub to our Rumble, where we go live now most of the time, and you get to see a bunch of videos that, well, that aren't with us anymore, and some new stuff. So be sure to check out the Rumble as well and sub. In a little bit. Can you get his plate from the front? Is that possible?
The lights are too bright.
Okay. Hey, sir. Hey, I got to talk to you about what's going on with Emily, okay? I got all the messages here. I'm just here to have a conversation, all right? Mind stepping out of the car?
What?
James Gay.
Who?
James Gay. I have every message here saved, all right? I know you live in Montour Falls, okay? We're just here to have a conversation with you, okay? I think that's probably the best option to take right now, all right? I think it's best we have a talk about this, because I have every single message saved, including penis pictures, okay? All right, so I got two other people with me for safety reasons, all right? But I think it's best we do have a talk because we already have your license plate, okay? And from the first message to the last message, you know, we have everything captured, okay? So let's just have a conversation about it. I think that's the easiest way so we can get through this, okay?
Okay.
All right, you mind stepping out?
Talking to my niece.
Hmm?
Talking to my niece right now.
Well, I mean, being that I have these messages, I mean, I think you should extend the courtesy of giving me a conversation here, all right?
Okay, we can talk right here.
Okay. So, being that I have these messages in your plate already, okay, we already have you coming to meet, all right? We already have all the penis pictures saved.
I'm not here to meet nobody. I stopped here to talk to my niece.
Okay, so I'm going to remind you, like, I'm trying to do you a solid here, okay? So I just want to have a talk outside, okay, because your hands are hidden right now, all right?
My hands are right here.
Okay.
I'll put my hand in here. I'll put this hand here, and I'll leave this hand right here.
Okay. So what I want to do is I want to have a talk under the gazebo over there, okay, because I think that's probably the safest thing to do for all both of us, okay? Now, I mean, you know, I mean, I think that's best being that I have these messages here, all right? Because, look, I know you're a good dude, you're a family man, okay? And you care about your people, but obviously there's something happened here that's probably not the most flattering thing, okay? So, look, I'm not judging you for what happened, but we do absolutely have to have a talk about it, in my opinion.
Okay.
So, if you may, please, let's go do that. My name is Gordon, by the way. Sorry to meet you like this.
Let my niece know that I'll be right back.
I can't make you do nothing about them.
So my niece and I were talking.
What's your niece's name?
Deborah.
Okay.
Yeah, she's a handicapped girl.
Oh. See, I mean, you care about people, I know. You can, you should probably shut the window. I guess nobody's here going to steal anything in Watkins Glen. It ain't New York City.
Well, they can't go nowhere anyways without this.
Oh, all right.
I just left Walmart not too long ago.
Pleasure to meet you, Gordon.
Nice meeting you.
Got it. All right, well, let's have this talk over there, if you don't mind.
I just left Walmart, I need calls, and goes, can we talk? I'm like, okay, let me pull off.
Mm-hmm. Do you have the donut holes, by the way?
Hmm?
Where's the donuts at?
They're in my car.
Okay.
But they were for my son.
Okay. Do you mind, real quick, if you can go get the donut holes?
Okay.
All right. Oh, and I got two people with me. The reason their cameras are there, so you can be assured I'm not here to hurt you or take anything from you, okay? I mean, maybe just the donut holes. Just kidding about that, but I just want to see the donut holes.
Okay, yeah, so they're for my son.
Okay. I'm just requesting you do it from this side, if you may. All right. All right, let's go into the gazebo. It's too dark out here. So what do you do for work? You're like, you work at the racetrack?
Yeah, I'm a flagger at the Watkins Glen International and a security guard up there.
Oh, awesome. I'm somewhat of a flagger, too. So you're like into racing and whatnot. Is it like NASCAR or is it just...
NASCAR.
So NASCAR does shit here?
Yep.
Okay. I'm all the way from Buffalo, so I don't really know. More of a football guy. That's cool. So who's your favorite racer?
I don't really like getting into favorite race car drivers.
Yeah. So... get up here. Is it out? All right, that'll be fine here. Okay.
West Main Street.
Okay. And what's your middle name?
D as in David.
Okay. Is it not Dwight?
Yeah.
Is Dwight? Okay. And what do you do for work?
Security. I'm a flagger.
Okay.
Watkins Glen International.
Got it, got it. What did you do before that, before you were a flagger?
Security guard.
Nice. And you were also a firefighter?
Yep.
Well, thank you for your service, man. You get a lot of fires over here in this part?
It varies.
Oh.
A lot of chimney fires here in the winter.
Oh, okay. Makes more sense. Okay. So, and you are also vaccinated?
Yes.
Okay. So it's fair to say that this is probably your profile photo then?
Yeah.
Okay. And this is your Facebook?
Yeah.
Okay. And since October 17th, and the reason I'm here talking to you is because since October 17th, there's been a girl named Emily from here that's been messaging you.
Okay.
Okay, and I think...
either me or it's my nephew, because my nephew also uses my Facebook.
Okay, so it's been both of you guys?
Yeah, my nephew mainly uses my Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Because I talk to my cousins, and that's about it.
Okay. Well, I mean, obviously, I mean, you were the one talking today because I think, I mean, we literally had you just a few minutes ago saying I'm here at the park, so. Okay, so you were the one messaging today?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. So, and who's your nephew?
James Dean.
And how old is he?
15.
Okay. So, the messages started here. I think you waved hello at her. She said hi. You said, how are you? And I mean, before we get into anything, like, I mean, I'm sure we both know the answer, but right now I'm just kind of seeing if we can get through this together or if we have to be combative because, you know, I think this obviously can be addressed with just a simple conversation. How old did Emily tell you she was?
I never asked her age. I never did. My nephew probably did.
Mm-hmm. Your nephew did. Well, she told you that she's 11 and you said cool, and she said, are you okay with my age? And you said yes. So I know at first, I know at first you didn't know her age or whatnot, but I think after she told you, that's when you started to know.
See, that's my nephew, most likely. Oh. That's my nephew.
Oh, this is your nephew?
That's my nephew.
Okay.
That's James Dean.
Okay, that's your nephew right here.
Yes.
Okay, so this is the 15-year-old boy.
Yes.
Okay, okay.
And he does a lot of things that I do not approve of.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, I see. So, because today, are you, like, still married right now?
Yes.
Okay. So, I mean, is there anything, like, going on at home? I see your Facebook kind of says it's complicated.
No, it's just I haven't changed it back to married.
Ah, okay. got it.
It's a rocky marriage. It's been like that for 3 years.
She wouldn't want to marry a fireman? Firefighter?
Yeah, she did.
Did she just get kind of jealous because you get all the hoes and stuff?
No.
Okay. Well, okay. So, I mean, that makes more sense. I mean, if you don't know that she told you her age or whatnot, that probably explains all the sexual stuff said.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. So basically, you know, because, you know, there's obviously some stuff said, like, you know, penis pictures sent. I mean, I don't think the penis pictures were your kid, or I'm sorry, your nephew. Because, I mean, that I know for sure. Like, because that's a 15-year-old's penis sent, then, you know, that's, I don't think he's slinging around child pornography. I think you sent those, but you just didn't know her age. I know it's, like, hard to talk about, man. I know, it's like...
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I have all these pictures saved here, man. I mean, it doesn't really... I mean, looking at the pubic hair and looking at... I hate to tell you, but the wrinkles of it, that obviously doesn't look like a kid's, you know? And, you know, compliment you, the size of it, too. I mean, as a kid's, I mean, geez Louise, he's definitely the guy fucking the high school teacher, you know? But, you know, obviously, I think you just sent a lot of these pictures without really knowing her age. Is that kind of what happened?
Most likely.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's your penis in there. I mean, because does your nephew live with you?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's your penis in there because it's not a kid's. Okay. So, I mean, if only you or the nephew used the account, it had to be one of you guys, and that's not a kid's penis that was sent. So, I mean, did you just send all those without knowing her age, or?
Yeah, most likely.
Well, I mean,
it's
not most likely. I mean, they were sent, but, I mean, it wasn't him sending it, so that leaves one person.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was you sending those.
Yeah.
But you just didn't know her age.
No.
Okay, okay. That makes sense. So, you knew it was this girl named Emily, but you just had no idea about her age?
No.
Okay.
Not at all.
Okay. So it was just some girl named Emily just messaging you from here, and you thought it was just an adult or something?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So, you know, I gotta ask. So basically, you know, because there was, of course, sexual talk today being said, right? Like, you know, I can't wait to touch you. We can do it here. Stuff like that. But if you didn't know her age, I mean, that obviously, I don't see no problem with it, but.
Okay.
I mean, was all that kind of said because you just didn't know her age either?
Yeah.
Okay. So obviously today, I mean, within the past 30 minutes, you remember saying, I can't wait to touch you, hee-hee.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So was that said because you just didn't know her age?
Yeah.
Okay. So...
Had I known her age, I would have been more of a gentle person. You know, I talk to a lot of females where I say, hey, have a good day.
Right. Oh, like a lot of people her age that are like, have a good day and whatnot.
Yeah.
Oh, know, okay.
Because I give them compliments. There's people out there that put themselves down.
Oh, like basically younger ladies under 18 online.
Yeah, and if I see that, I mean, I'm friends with different friends.
Oh yeah.
And if I see that, I was like, you know, no, you're not ugly. You know, you're.
You boost their confidence.
I boost their confidence.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, I really appreciate that.
I've done that for many years.
Oh, like to basically kids online?
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. Awesome.
Even in person, I boost their confidence in person.
Oh, well, that's exceptional. You used to also be an elementary school teacher, right?
Yes, I used to work for Skyler Head Start.
Oh, awesome. What did you teach?
I was a fireman, firefighter teacher.
Mm-hmm.
I taught them fire safety.
Okay. Stop, drop, and roll?
Yep, stop, drop, and roll. I'd go there with a turnout gear, show them what a fireman looks like in turnout gear.
Uh-huh. Oh, well, that's exceptional, man. That's really awesome. So I guess today, I mean, you know, obviously the past couple of days, it's been a lot of, and you know, like I said, I mean, if it's a rocky marriage and, you know, because I've been on hookup apps, I've been on Tinder, Facebook, I've been around the block, Bumble. But, you know, obviously there was a lot of sexual talk back and forth between you and Emily. But, you know, if you didn't know her age, then that's obviously probably explains it, you know. So I think, so basically you were here for like a sexual hookup, but you just didn't know that it was you just didn't know her age.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, you guys were going to, and I'm sure you weren't going to like force yourself at all.
No.
Okay. So basically you came here to basically touch and, you know, have this girl play with your penis thinking it was an adult.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. So the reason for being here was sexual, but you just didn't know with who.
Right.
Okay, awesome. So, all right. So let's try to sift through who said what here, because you know obviously Emily did say she was 11 years old, but if you're a nephew is the one receiving that. I mean, you know.
Yeah, because my nephew uses my phone at night while I'm in bed, because I get up early in the morning and go to work.
Okay. Oh, at the raceway? You work at the raceway all day?
Yeah, we're open. I'm open. We're getting ready to shut down, so I'm working until December 20th.
Okay. Oh, okay. Okay. So when was the last race that was here?
Our last race was 2 weeks ago, 4 or 3 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
Which was like a closed event, but...
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So here... Okay, so here, somebody asked you, like, naughty boy, and you said hi, or I'm sorry, your cousin said hi, nephew said hi. She said, if you don't care, I'm 11. And somebody said, I don't care what you're doing, I have a question for you. Do you like boys that can show on cam?
My nephew.
Okay. So you remember all this stuff being said, but it was from your nephew?
I don't remember them all being said.
Right, but this would have been your nephew.
My nephew likes to show on cam.
Okay. Can I see a picture of you? Want to view my cam? Do you mind boys that show on cam? Okay. So I assume your nephew is probably thinking about showing his penis on video call.
Yeah, most likely.
Okay. Pictures of it. Okay. Let's see if pictures out of yes. Okay, so when the actual penis pictures were being shown, that would have been on your end. That would have been from you.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, does it bother you that I sent you a picture of my penis? Want to see it on cam? Okay, so this is after you sent that penis picture, and then somebody asks here, does it bother you that I just sent you a picture of my penis after a video call? Okay. It's kind of a weird. And then I think this had to have been your nephew. Your nephew sent a message basically talking about raping and kidnapping. Your nephew said, I want to take you to the forest and pull down your pants and tie you up and rape you.
Yeah, that would be my nephew. Okay. Something that he's told many people.
Okay. Well, that was never said, James. And
No, I'm just saying.
Right. Yeah, okay.
I'm just saying that something that he would, it wouldn't surprise me that he'd say that.
Right. Okay. Well.
Because he's told, I've had some people tell me that's what he's told them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
You know, but I'm just saying that's something that I wouldn't be surprised if he did say
right.
that.
Right. Okay. Okay. Okay, you said, yeah, I know you like my dick, LOL. Oh, hee, I bet you want to see it again. So this would have been yours, right? You know you like, yeah, I know you like my dick. That would have had to be you after. Because I know you weren't only sending penis pictures. That wouldn't make any sense. But, you know, of course, she doesn't say her age on this page. So this had to be you right here, huh? Yeah, I know you like my dick. Because you had just sent it. And then she said, oh, hee. So these messages had to be on your end, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is also your penis here. Do you want to see it again? I'm willing to show you it again if you want to send it. And you sent your penis again here, right?
Yeah, most likely.
Well, I mean,
knowing the age.
Right. Right. And then she says, "Oh, hee, I'm in New York. How about you?" And it is. So you're probably the one that said you're also in New York, right? Same.
I don't remember saying same.
Okay. Well, I mean,
I don't remember.
Okay. Okay.
You know, so.
But I think you were the one that said, "Bet you want to play with it." Of course, not knowing her age. Or asking her to play. I mean, that's what was here today here for. I mean, playing with it today. I mean, here we said, "Bet you want to play with it" a few days ago on October 28th.
Possible.
Okay. And she said, "How would I do that?" And she said, "I'm 11. I'm new to all of this. Sorry." And she said, "Sorry again." And then you said, "Any way you want," after she said she was 11. Did you go and visit Elmira a few weeks ago?
I don't go down here very often.
Mm-hmm. Well, were you there 10 days ago. I know you don't go down there every day, but I just think, I'm just curious about Elmira because I got a grandma down there and, you know, I think you mentioned in the messages you were there and just curious. I like it there.
Well, Elmira's a nice place. I mean, I go down here to take my client down there.
Oh, what do you have a client for?
I'm a home health aide.
Oh, nice. Oh, so were you there like, do you go like a couple times a month then or something?
Yeah, whenever she has to go down here for appointments.
Okay, so that's why you were there like late October?
Probably.
Okay.
I mean, I don't recognition. I'd have to look at my calendar.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, because I take her all over.
Yeah. Well, you know, then she, I mean, when she asked, "Where in New York are you?" She said, "I'm in Watkins." And then you said, "I'm in Elmira right now." And this was a little bit after the penis picture was sent, after she said her age. So, you know, James, I was kind of gauging how, and you were mostly honest. I give you credit for that. I was kind of gauging to see how honest everything was here. But we already traced that picture that you said was your nephew back to something from online. Okay, if I remember correctly, it's somebody on TikTok, all right? So.
Oh, that would have been my nephew.
Okay. So, the thing is, James, all right? I already know that, I think you just got a little bit carried away with these messages, because I already know that you do uplift people online, and I think your marriage is rocky, and this is why all of this happened. But I know it's not your nephew sending these messages, because, and look, I don't blame you for not telling me the truth about that, and for just saying untruths, okay? Because I mean, if I was in your position, I know it's hard to talk about. It's not the most flattering thing to say, but come on, man, that's not your nephew. And don't throw, if your nephew even exists, which I'm sure he does, don't throw him under the bus like this, dude. You don't send a penis picture and then attempt a video call right after the penis picture and say, "That's my nephew." Unless you guys were just handing off the phone to each other. But come on, man. you got a little bit carried away. All right, you're not a bad person. You weren't here to kidnap or rape anybody. You told me that. But you did get a little bit carried away. And as a knee-jerk reaction, which makes total sense, I'm not judging you for not telling the truth about this, because when someone's back is against the wall, like, oh shit, of course the truth isn't gonna come out. I mean, that's human nature. It's not, you know, if you told the full truth, I think you're a sociopath, because you wouldn't even have a conscience about this. But look, we traced those photos back. All right, I was gonna see when you were gonna cut out the BS, but it seems like I had to do it, okay? And I already gauged your reaction when I asked you, what did you do for work? What's your name? When you're telling the truth and answering something, you answer it quick. You don't answer it with slow speech, okay? But when I started asking you about your nephew sending this, you took, gosh damn, I think 20 seconds to answer me, to think of something, okay? So, look, I want to get through this together, but it's going to have to start with, and look, because I don't think you need trouble. I just think maybe you need some help, or maybe you need some counseling. But if that's the case, then it's time to tell the truth that these messages were sent from you. So can we cut the bullshit, James?
Okay.
Okay. So they were all sent from you. Your nephew didn't send any of these. Is that right? See?
Yeah.
Okay. So you knew her age after she told you the first time. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. So since you just told me you were here for sexual reasons at the very beginning of this conversation that we had, and then that you knew her age the whole time, that tells me that you were here to meet an 11-year-old, because you knew her age the whole time, because you told me what you were here for. You were here to meet an 11-year-old.
Originally, I stopped here originally to talk to my niece.
Okay.
Okay, and then after
we
I got
saw
done,
that you took a picture of this, okay? James, look, at this point, what needs to happen is we just both need to be honest with each other, because we both know what happened, and we need to understand why this happened, dude. Look, man, because I really don't think you're a bad guy. I mean, we need more people working nowadays, and especially in this fucking economy, right?
Yeah, I can agree.
Yeah. So, look, when did this type of attraction start for you, man?
I don't remember.
Okay.
I honestly don't remember.
And I'm going to ask some tough questions here, okay? But look, there's a reason I'm not, like, standing in your car doing this. We're drawing attention from people, okay? There's a reason that we're just talking here so nobody around can hear what's going on, all right? Because the last thing I want to happen is have someone that's a family man who cares about people, who works, have their life turned upside down, mm-hmm. Okay? But you said you can't remember when this attraction started for you, and you know what I mean, right? To minors. Mm-hmm. Was it like during high school, after high school?
During.
During. I mean, and I'm not talking about you were 16, you found like a freshman cute. I mean, like, you know, you're in high school, you're 16, 17, 18, and you're starting to find like 11, 12-year-olds cute. Is that kind of when it started?
Mm-mm. Yeah, before that.
Before that?
When I was in seventh grade.
Seventh grade, you started finding like younger kids attractive?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Like toddlers or infants or?
No.
Just like elementary school kids?
Yeah.
Okay. And did it kind of, so the gap just started getting bigger and bigger and bigger? Like you got older and your attraction stayed the same?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, all right. I mean, it happens, dude. Were you molested as a kid?
Yes.
Okay, so that's probably what it is. Who, if I may ask, who did it?
My uncle.
Okay. And I can see that you're probably telling the truth about that because you answered it quickly. You see how when you tell the truth, it's quick, but when you honestly were some bullshit, like it's...
Yeah,
my uncle. Yeah. All right. I'm here for you, man. I'm not here to judge, all right? So, you know, you also mentioned to Emily that... You also mentioned to Emily that years ago in Rochester, where you used to live, that there was a 12-year-old on the bus What happened with her?
Not much of anything. We hugged, hung out.
Mm-hmm. Was she a relative or just someone random?
Random.
You met her on the bus?
Mm-hmm.
Was that when you were working at the school?
Yes.
Okay. You say you were the bus driver?
Bus monitor.
Bus monitor. Okay. And, you know, because Emily asked you, have you been with somebody? You said you've been with this 12-year-old. So what was the extent of it? Because, you know, it was more than hugging.
No, we just basically hugged. I mean, I'd give her a kiss on the cheek.
I mean, it's
sexual.
Okay. I know you guys didn't have full-on intercourse, okay?
No.
Okay, but I'm letting you know that I got in touch with her, man. All right? And I know it's so hard to talk about, and you obviously have a guilty conscience about it, which I appreciate, okay? Because you're not a monster. You're somebody that's needed help for a long time and just never got it. But it was more than just hugging. It was some groping there. Okay. How many times did you guys grope each other?
We never groped. To be honest with you, we just mainly hugged and gave kisses on the cheek.
Okay.
To be honest.
Okay.
I knew her mother. I knew her mother. I went to school with her mother.
Okay. But you definitely got aroused doing it.
I can't say yes or no because I don't remember.
Okay. It was hugs and kisses on the cheek.
Mm-hmm.
I know there was kisses on the lip too. Some, not always. A few times.
I don't remember.
Do you think it's a possibility that could have happened?
It's possible, but okay. I don't remember.
Okay. Do you kind of try to block out that memory?
No. It's just I have, I suffer from memory loss.
Mm-hmm.
Ever since I was a kid, I black out a lot of my childhood, you know, and I try to black out a lot of stuff.
Yeah, because of what happened to you?
Yeah.
Okay. So how long were you a bus monitor for?
7 years.
So how long ago did you and this 12-year-old girl kiss? Or how long ago did it happen?
6.5 years ago.
Okay. Where would you guys kiss and hug?
I do it on the bus.
Come on, man.
No, I give her a hug before she left before she got off the bus.
Okay. So if you told Emily that you've been with this 12-year-old, been with doesn't mean, because I've given, you know, if there's somebody younger in my family, like a younger cousin or something, I've given them hugs, you know, or even mm-hmm. a kiss on the forehead. But that doesn't really register in my mind that I've been with them. That, you know, I've shown affection to my family members.
To the 12-year-old.
Okay, so I'm about to...
Wasn't sexual.
So today was going to be the first time something sexual would happen with a minor with you?
Yeah.
Okay. So... I'd let you touch it, anything you want. So it wasn't gonna be like sex today, it was just gonna be like touching everywhere pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Was it gonna be one side, like just her touching you, or is it gonna be a mutual thing, like you touching her back? Or was it whatever she wanted?
Whatever she wanted.
Okay. So you would only like basically touch her vagina if she consented to it? Okay. So, here you ask, but would you ever send pictures of your vagina or chest? Okay. So, did she ever send you a picture of her vagina? You just asked her? You asked her to?
No, I didn't ask her to. I just asked if she would.
Just wondering if you're willing to do it. Maybe why? Can I see them? See what? Your vag and chest?
I don't remember. That's why I said I don't recall.
Memory loss?
Memory loss.
Okay. So you just asked her if she'd be willing to send those?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, anyway, so...
Shoot.
Oh, yeah. Fuck. Is that a Italian place still open here?
I think so.
Yeah, just see if they have the pickles.
Okay.
Okay. So, here, I mean, would you ask, would you send the kind of pictures we talked about earlier? And look, I know it wasn't forceful or anything. That's obviously you asking her, man. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's when you asked her?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to try to bring up these messages here. Are you in the village? Do you have a boyfriend? You asked her, do you want to be my girlfriend? She said, yes, I love you. Blah, blah, blah. I mean, what was the plan with this boyfriend-girlfriend thing? I mean, were you going to tell anybody about this, or?
I don't know what you call that.
Okay. So, I mean, if this attraction has been going on for, gosh, I mean, you're 43 now?
Mm-mm.
How old?
You're off by a year.
Oh, 44? 44, okay.
No, now you're off by 2 years.
Oh, 42?
Yes.
Okay, okay.
You look young, I thought you were like 35.
Why, thank you. Wow, that is, I take that as a compliment. Thank you.
Yeah.
I try to look young.
Yeah. I mean, not young enough for this not to be illegal, but, you know, still young enough.
I take that as a compliment.
Yeah, no, you look good for your age, for sure. God, if you knew how old I was, you'd be shocked. Okay. Let's see. All right, so you have Telegram, right?
Telegram?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like the app Telegram?
No.
Okay. So, I mean, with you know, you had this girl on the bus. I mean, is there any other times? Because, I mean, I dug damn deep, man. Is there any other times where you got maybe a little bit carried away and it was just, okay. So, so basically for 30 years, 30 years, middle school for you. I mean, 12, 13, 11, whatever. 31 to 29 years, you've had this attraction to minors and whatnot. So, how would you channel it? I mean, obviously you're here today, the 12-year-old on the bus, but how would you channel it? I wanna ask, you know, I just wanna test your honesty one more time. What was the 12-year-old's name on the bus?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth what?
I don't remember.
You went to school with her mom.
Yeah, her mother's name was Neil. O'Neill.
Neil?
O'Neill.
Oh, her last name.
Yeah, O'Neill.
Elizabeth O'Neill, okay.
That was her mother's maiden name.
Yeah, if you said Neil, I thought you did some research on me.
No, O'Neill.
Oh, okay. O'Neill. All right. Youngest I've been with was 12, but 11. Okay. You said you met her on a bus. So she's in Rochester, right? Okay. So, I mean, look, man. So, whatever happened with you and Elizabeth O'Neill on the bus, that is, I mean, she told me some more things than what you told me. I mean, I get it's hard to talk about, but, you know, I'm going to stop drilling you on it, but if you want to come clean to me about what really happened, like she did, you should probably do it. But anyway, so 30 years of this attraction happening. How, I mean, obviously you've been online. This is your first time meeting someone off the internet?
No.
No?
I met my cousin's best friend online.
Your younger cousin?
Mm-mm.
Okay, same age. Okay. How many younger ladies under 18 have you met off the internet before?
None.
This was going to be the first?
Yeah.
Okay. So, So it's just been talking. You said you talk to kids on the internet, but that's all it's been?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I get it. I'm sure some of it has been uplifting. I mean, you're obviously a good guy that cares about people. Okay. Can't dispute that, honestly. But, you know, if the chats with Emily were like this, I know it was like that with some of the other ones too. Just kind of, let's video call, camming, showing penises, whatnot. I'm correct, aren't I?
She was the first one, to be honest.
You took too long to answer that, so I know how that works for you. So not the first one you talked to, just the first one you talked sexually to?
Yes.
Okay. So the other ones, were they about Emily's age, like 11, 12?
Mm-mm.
How old were they?
14 and up.
Yeah. Were they in Watkins too?
Mm-mm.
Just in the USA somewhere?
Yeah.
Okay. Did, you know, I mean, obviously, I know what happens when you have rocky marriages. It does get sexual online, but I mean, maybe Emily's the first one you initiated the sexual talk with. Did any of them ever initiate it with you?
Yes.
Okay. So you've been a part of sexual conversations, but the kids always would initiate it first?
Yes.
Okay. And let me guess, they never met you or anything?
Nope.
They would just send you nudes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, these like 14-year-olds?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, that makes a little more sense. And so you would send nudes back?
At times.
Okay, got it.
Not 100%.
Right. Times. Okay. So basically, you know, were these nude images that these kids would send you, was it like them in a video of somebody or just like a full body nude picture?
Partial
nudes? Okay. So basically like child pornography. That's a term for it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. When's the last time one of them sent you that?
A year ago.
Okay. Give me a ballpark of how many of them sent you like those type of images.
Oh boy.
Oh, that's a lot, huh?
No, I'm trying to think. 25?
20, 20, 25 kids?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so there's probably some stuff on your phone you should probably delete right now, right?
Oh, I delete them.
Oh, you delete the images they send you?
Yeah.
Okay. I see. Were any from New York?
Nope.
No? Okay. You were born here in Montour, right?
Nope.
Where are you born?
Rochester.
Oh, okay.
I'm a Rochester stomping ground area.
You're a Republican from Rochester?
Yes.
Wow. You're just a rare breed.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Well, that's very cool.
But I was raised around this area.
Oh, okay. So you're conceived there, but you're kind of, you're from, like, okay, so your home's here.
Yeah.
Okay.
I should say that. I mean, I grew up in Montour.
Yeah. I see. So have you ever been, like, do you have like a Twitter and whatnot?
No.
When's the food going to be ready?
It's here.
Oh, they're here?
I think delivery, like I just got a text from DoorDash that they just arrived.
Oh, what the hell? Fucking starving. God, I'm hungry. Dude, okay. So, I mean, now we cut through a lot of it. Those donut holes were to give to Emily, right?
No, these were to give for my son.
Okay, well, you took a picture of the donut holes and sent it to Emily. And you said the day before you were going to bring them to her. I mean, that's at least, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, but I mean.
Yeah, but I bought them for my son.
Oh, all right.
Because he's been, whenever he's good at school, you know, and for a few days, I reward him with a little treat.
Okay. Awesome. Well, can I call you daddy? Just so I can have the donut holes. So I can be your son.
You want them?
No, it's okay. Sure? No, give it to him. Give it to him. I'm fat, but I'm not ruthless, you know? But, yeah, okay. So basically, so how many years has the online conversations been going on with kids?
Probably 3, 4.
Yeah. Has it only been on Facebook or Twitter or
Facebook?
All Facebook. Just basically teen dating groups.
No, I don't. I'm not in any teen dating groups. Just
you just find them, or they find you,
yeah.
Vice versa. Okay. So you have an Instagram as well?
Nope.
No, it's all on Facebook.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So have, and you know what I care about, because you know obviously you're someone that has been carried away and has had stuff happen to you. So obviously you're not a monster. You know, you were kind of made a certain way due to unfair circumstances.
Uh-huh.
But what I really want to catch is the true monsters who exploit children and whatnot. Have there been any adults that would send you like basically child porn images?
Yes.
Oh, there are adults that do that?
Yes.
Yeah, because that's who I care about. You know.
And I delete them.
Uh-huh. Do they send it to you on Facebook?
Yes.
Okay. When's the last, I mean, they just spam you, don't they?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. When's the last time one of them sent you an image like that?
A month ago?
Okay. So, you know, obviously, I know you kind of get carried, and you know, the internet takes good people like you and kind of swindles them into being part of shit they shouldn't be a part of. When's the first time you like, and I'm sure you know to delete it, but you know, when's the first time you like save one of these images?
I don't save them.
No, it's all in the chat?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not into saving.
You just save human lives with being a firefighter.
That's right.
Okay, there you go.
I'd rather risk my own life and save somebody else's.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, that's very it's very noble of you. Well, I think you should probably stick to saving cats and trees rather than chasing pussy on the internet.
Yeah.
But okay. But anyway, we can. Oh gosh, I don't. Where did he come from?
Yeah, what's going on?
How's it going, sir?
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, he's here.
This man's here to meet who he thought was an 11-year-old girl.
Okay.
We're part of a group called Predator Closures that does this across the country, and we were the ones like messaging him.
Okay.
So who is involved with your organization?
It's us three right here.
You three.
Yeah.
Do you have text messages?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Take a look there. Yeah, all your these aren't all the text messages, but he, you know, we printed it out like earlier today, so he's texted since then. But he's admitted to molesting a kid before, and well, being with a 12-year-old, and
what's your name, sir?
James.
Do you have an ID on you by chance?
Not on me.
Okay.
I'm on my way home to my son and my wife.
And he admitted that he was here to basically molest who he thought was his kid. And he said that over the course of the years, he's probably talked to 20 to 25 minors online and has received child porn from numerous adults and numerous of the kids he would talk to. I mean, it's all on camera. He said it on his own free will, under no threats.
All right, well, I'll look over that a little bit later.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll give them back to you to hold on for me.
Sure.
All right, so I just want to make sure I get the story straight. How long have you guys been?
October 17th. Okay. He messaged first then, and okay. We just responded.
Okay. Now you guys just set up like a fake account kind of thing? And
yes, sir. We do this all across New York, and in July we had two people arrested in Bath for the same thing.
Okay. I have to make a phone call to my district attorney. She's looking for a phone call back. And be right back with you guys, okay?
Okay.
But for right now, I want you all to stay here. Stay here.
All right.
And you, sir, are not free to leave yet.
Okay, well, I got to get home to my wife and my son.
All right, well, I'm just telling you right now, you're not free to leave. I got to make phone calls, and we'll go from there, okay? All right.
Do you mind if I go to my car so I can have a cigarette and get a drink?
You can have a cigarette, but you're staying right here.
Okay. Well, no, I'm just saying.
I'm not letting you leave. That's
well, no, I'm just saying I need to go get a drink and my throat is dry and I need a cigarette.
Well, let me make a phone call and I'll let you do that.
Okay.
All right. Hey. So, let's set up this thing.
audacity. Who does he think he is? Does he like think that?
Does he just,
does he just think that admitting all this on camera, there's gonna be like, he just, okay, can I leave now? These people are so stupid. How many people we got in there?
1,800.
Okay. Was the light good during the catch?
Yeah.
Dude, that was a good catch.
Yeah.
I got him to like admit sexual intent, like saying, oh, you didn't know the age, but you were here to have sex and all that.